Hi guys, welcome back. If you are not able to see Robo Framework log on Jenkins, don't worry. We are going to solve that issue with a permanent fix. But before I start the video, I would request you to subscribe to this channel because when you subscribe and like this video, you really help us grow on YouTube, and it also encourages us to make more such videos in the future for you. So to start with the video, let's understand how did I land up on this page. This is a simple Jenkins job that I have created for the demo, and you can see few logs are already generated over here. And if you open this log now, you get this error. Now to fix this error, let's understand what does it mean. Basically, when you execute Robo Framework test cases, it will execute, it will generate some HTML files as a logs, and that HTML file content is not allowed on Jenkins. It contains some JavaScript and some stuff which is not allowed on Jenkins, because Jenkins see it as a security risk. So Jenkins content security policy does not allow you to print the Robo Framework log. And if you want to see Robo Framework log on Jenkins, you'll have to modify content security policy of Jenkins. Now before I discuss the different ways to modify content security policy, I would recommend you to discuss this with your DevOps guys or your security team, so that you know you are going to modify the security policy. If your Jenkins is publicly facing, then you better check with them. If it is secure enough, it is, if it is behind firewall, or if it is your private Jenkins, then you can probably go ahead and modify this content security policy. Now, to modify the content security policy, let's go to Manage Jenkins and just find the script console where I'll be executing few scripts to modify content security policy. These scripts are mentioned in the description, so you don't need to note it down. Okay, so I have executed it. Now if I go and refresh the page, I can see the log. Great. But the problem with this approach is, if you restart the Jenkins service, these settings will go away. Let's say refresh. Okay. See, the logs are not showing up again. So issue is reproduced. Now to how to fix this issue in permanent way. For that, you need to find the Jenkins installation directory, which is in program files. And then here you can see jenkins.xml. Open that file, and you'll have to add this system property before the jar, before you execute the jar. Okay, so I have already done these changes here, and this is also mentioned in the description. Okay, so what this basically means, you are setting content security policy of Jenkins to blank string. This basically allows everything, every content on the Jenkins. So this is most relaxed content security policy. And then after you save those changes, just restart your Jenkins server. Okay, and then let's try to refresh our page. See, you are able to see the logs now, and this will stay here even if you restart the Jenkins. And this is kind of permanent fix for you now. In case it does not work even after restarting Jenkins, you better clear the cache of browser. It should work for you. So yeah, that's it for the video, friends. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye bye.